That she went away to school, a half an hour to Grand Rapids, to Calvin College?
Learning is about the exchange of ideas, and if you don't have the freedom to debate and discuss ideas freely, you don't really have learning, ultimately. And I think there is a real issue with many campuses today, and I hear examples regularly of either subtle or overt efforts to silence some discussion and to elevate other discussion, and we're not doing any young person a service by doing so. Able to attend a micro school in that same school building. Our president and I have both continued to speak out on this issue very, very vocally, and I think that is helping to foster more discussion about what that actually means and what that looks like. I think we have to keep the pressure on institutions to really do what it, to really fulfill what their role is as a higher ed institution, and that is to be a facilitator of idea exchange.
List your state person, a county person, a town person.
I'm very much in favor of shrinking the federal role in education and have been endeavoring to do so in all the ways that I'm empowered to do as education secretary and will continue to. There are a couple of areas that, a couple of laws that have to be administered and observed, but I think the most important consideration is to empower states in the way that it was originally intended. And when you think about the fact that only about 8% of education spending in general comes from the federal government, the federal government has had a very outsized role for its investment. And I think we need to get that very much back in balance.
Well, this is an ideas summit, and you have big ideas.
Education Freedom Scholarships is a proposal from the administration. It has corresponding bills that have been introduced in both the House and the Senate now. And what it would do is create a federal tax credit that individuals and corporations could contribute to voluntarily, and states could elect to participate or not participate. It's a choice. If they do participate, they would be able to create a program or programs to expand choices for families and students in K-12 education in that particular state.